The gyms are still closed and many of us are beginning to feel a little unmotivated, stuck at home. And chances are, you're watching this either sitting on the toilet or laying on the couch, covered in crumbs, cat hair, and shame. Well, damn it, it's time to get up and get motivated with the Buff Dude's home workout routine. We're gonna be hitting every major muscle group over a 5-day period. Arms, chest, back, even legs. They're all here and they're waiting for you. So delete that overpriced dumbbell from your wish list and finish up with your poop, because it's time for the pump. Day one is gonna be focused on the most neglected but largest and arguably most important muscle group there is, legs. We're creatures of motion and laying around all day isn't doing any of us favors. So let's build those wheels. Reverse front stationary lunges working on the quads and glutes. To begin this exercise, start in the standing position with feet hip width apart. Kick one leg back behind you in line with the hip and land on the toes with the forward foot still flat on the ground. Flex both of your knees and lower your back leg knee just above the ground. Using the front leg as a pivot point, move the back leg into the front lunge position. Go back and forth doing this in a fluid motion. Some tips you want to keep in mind is don't let the knee go too far over the toes and you want to keep a vertical torso while performing the exercise. Lateral squats, working the quads and glutes. This variation of squats uses unilateral movement and puts more weight on one side and then the other. To begin, get into a stance much wider than shoulder width. Go down, leaning towards one leg while keeping your torso upright. Go as deep as you can, preferably 90 degrees. Get back to the center top position. Some tips to keep in mind is make sure your stance is really wide, probably much wider than you think it should be to get the proper range of motion. You're also gonna wanna keep your toes pointed forward. Don't let them flare out. This may take a little time to get down, so be sure and practice. Single leg Romanian deadlifts, working the hamstrings and glutes. Start in a standing position with feet hip width apart. Support yourself with one leg as you kick the opposite one back while flexing at the hips and letting your torso bow forward. Let the supporting leg's knee bend slightly but keep it stationary as to create more tension and stretch in the hamstring. Your elevated back leg and torso should be parallel with the ground in the end position. Using your hamstring, extend your hips and pull yourself back to the top position, bringing your back leg knee up to your chest. Work within your flexibility and don't let your back bend. You want to keep it rigid and straight. Also, what could help is pick a spot on the floor and look at it in order to help keep your balance. Next, we're moving on to the single leg glute bridges, working, as their name implies, glutes. Lay down facing up with knees bent and feet flat on an elevated surface at hip width and raise one leg off the ground. Push with the foot that's placed on the ground and extend the hips upward until your upper and lower body are in line with one another. Squeeze the glutes and slowly lower yourself down to the starting position. Keep tension in the glutes by not completely resting your hips on the ground at the starting position. Calf reaches, which, again, is working what the name implies, calves. With feet hip width apart, raise your arms and push the balls of your feet into the ground as you elevate your heels. Slowly lower yourself until your heels are flat on the ground. The tips to keep in mind are slow and controlled on this one. Don't just bounce up and down. So that wraps it up. Day one is finished, and on day two, we'll be moving on to the second largest muscle group, back. And before we move on to back, I want to take a moment to talk about food. When you're stuck at home, the temptation to eat is always just a stroll to the fridge away. So why not take that stroll and grab yourself a crisp, refreshing Olipop? It's less than 50 calories a can. It's low sugar, low net carb, high fiber, gluten-free, non-GMO, paleo-friendly, vegan, keto-friendly, nothing artificial. At the end of the day, and since the dawn of time, we've always just been bacteria. Each of us possess our own unique microbiome, a multi-trillion size army of single-cell organisms that protect us against germs, break down our meals, release energy, and produce vitamins. It's our job to feed the little armies that live within us so that they can continue to fight to keep us healthy. Olipop tastes exactly like your favorite sodas from your childhood, but super nutritious and good for your gut health. You can drink 1 to 2 per day, guilt-free. Most of your typical sodas contain high sugar, carbs, and calories. Olipop is the exact opposite. At only 35 calories, it satisfies your sweet tooth cravings and you'll never think of having a normal soda again. So click our link below to get 20% off their best-selling variety pack, plus free shipping. It includes all six flavors. It's the perfect way to reward yourself after the workout, and you can't find this deal in stores. Got it? Good. Now let's go hit some back. We'll be beginning this workout with floor pullovers. When you're working out from home, certain muscle groups can be harder to hit than others, and the back is one of them. Thankfully, we've got a towel, and with it, we'll be performing floor pullovers, an excellent exercise which engages the lats. Put your knees on the towel and using your lats, pull them forward in a slow and controlled manner, squeezing your shoulder blades together as you reach top position. Once you're there, push your knees back to their original position and rinse and repeat. Inverted rows. Take a grip wider than shoulder width and hang yourself underneath the table. Your body should be straight and your feet on the ground with your arms fully extended. Pull yourself up by bending your elbows and bringing your chest as close to the table as possible. Hold for about 1 to 2 seconds on the top position while retracting your scapula and flexing the muscles of your back before going back to the starting position. We'll be supersetting this exercise with scapula pushes, an excellent exercise to strengthen your upper back, especially your traps. To perform this one, get into the push-up position, your hands slightly outside shoulder width. Keep your trunk and arms straight with your feet together. Bring your scapula together and squeeze. Once squoze, go back to a protracted position. Use this exercise to work on your scapula movement control in order to prepare for other back exercises like pull-ups, barbell rows, and more. Dive bombers. Working the chest, shoulders, and back. Start with hands flat on the floor, slightly wider than shoulder width. Arms straight, hips in the air, legs straight, and feet hip width apart. You should look like an inverted V. In a fluid motion, flex your elbows, bringing your head closer to the ground, arching your back and extending your hips. As you reach the position resembling the bottom part of a push-up, extend with your elbows while keeping your hips low to the ground. Reverse the motion back into the beginning position. Machine gun sounds optional. Keep this motion slow and controlled. Hold for a count at the end position. Reverse snow angels. Lie on the ground face down with your feet together. Get your head up, slightly arching your back. Your sternum should be firmly placed on the ground. Straighten your arms in front of you, keeping it just a few inches above the ground. Rotate your arms downwards all the way to your hips. Keep them straight the entire time. Once finished, come back to the starting position, keeping your arms, chest, and head up all the while. We're gonna be supersetting this one with something super, Superman's, which will be working the lower back. To perform this one, lay down on your stomach with your hands fully extended in front of you. Raise your hands and feet vertically up by arching your lower back. Keep them straight the entire time. Once extended, go back to the starting position, but don't stay on flex. Immediately do the next repetition. Now we're on to dolphin kicks. Place the upper half of your body on a chair, couch, or table facing down. Hold onto your support with your hands above your head. Your legs should be slightly above the ground as a starting position. Raise your legs up by arching your lower back and keep your feet together. Put your legs down, but instead of letting them rest on the ground, stop a few inches above it and start the next repetition. It's gonna be a great exercise for lower back and glutes. And that wraps up day two. And on day three, we're going to be engaging the chesticles. And remember, each of our workouts are going to last 45 minutes on average with 30 to 60 second rest times between sets. And with each day of this plan, you can choose to take a day off in between or power through all five for a Monday through Friday split. The choice is up to you, but the important thing is that you get it done. So let's do exactly that by moving on to chest. And our first exercise is going to be the wide to close grip push-ups, utilizing a dynamic movement in a fluid motion to alternate between the two. To begin, get into a standard push-up position with your hands shoulder width and bring yourself to the floor. And once you return to top position, spring your hands into a wider position, bringing them down once again before returning back to your top position. This is a hell of a way to get day three started, and the pump is only gonna grow from here. Focusing more on the clavicular portion of the chest, which is a smaller portion which can sometimes be neglected, we'll be moving on to decline push-ups in order to make sure we're leaving no muscle group behind, the clavicular included. In order to perform this exercise, elevate your legs using a couch, table, or chair, and once finished, immediately flip yourself around to burn out with as many reps as possible performing incline push-ups. Dips. Grab a set of chairs and position yourself between them. As the exercise can focus either on triceps or chest, depending on your positioning, make sure you flare your elbows wide and concentrate more on the stretch at the bottom position and less at the lockout at top position. As an extra bonus, you'll really be engaging that core as well, with your knees tucked tight to chest in order to clear the floor below you. We'll be ending day three with a little additional core work in the form of planks, an excellent isometric strength building exercise. Get into a push-up position and bring your forearms to the floor, keeping your body straight and flexing in your lats, glutes, and abs for the 30-second duration. Boom! Chest is finished, and we're over halfway finished with our at-home bodyweight workout routine. Day four is going to be shoulders, and shoulders cannot be neglected as they're one of the most mobile joints in your body. So they're a pretty important part of the muscle pyramid, and we're going to be utilizing them first in an exercise called elevated pike push-ups. The elevated pike push-ups are a great compound movement for your shoulders. And to perform, you're going to want to take a position similar to a normal push-up, but with your legs on a chair, table, or couch. Your body should create an inverted V-like shape. Next, slowly lower yourself down. Press yourself up, imitating a shoulder press exercise. And if they're proving too tough, you can choose not to elevate your feet and perform the exercise with your feet simply on the floor. Next are LYTs, and they're an exercise which don't look that taxing, but once you're on your second or third set, you'll quickly realize why we included them in our shoulders routine. It's a three-movement exercise working on mobility, stabilization, and endurance. It's a real deltoid burner. And like the name explains, you'll be bending over and raising your arms in three different positions, emulating an L, then a Y, then a T. Doing the three of them back to back to back consists of one rep, and you'll be doing it 15 times. Push-back push-ups. Begin by getting into the push-up position. Lower yourself down into the bottom position. And instead of pushing straight up like in a standard push-up, push backwards, letting your knees bend and your hips flex. Keep your arms straight and extend your knees and hips in order to return to the starting position. You're gonna wanna concentrate on pushing with the shoulders and making it a fluid motion. Next are wall slides, which is another exercise which looks kinda easy, similar to the LYTs, but wall slides are all about endurance, and with each one of the 15 reps, that statement becomes more and more a reality. To perform, go into a seated position and put your back against a wall. Raise your hands and arms in a V all the way up, keeping it connected to the wall in the process. Slowly bring your arms down by bending your elbows until your elbows touch your sides. Try and really flex and squeeze your delts and traps in the top and bottom position to get the full benefits of the exercise. We'll be wrapping up day four with a core exercise where shoulders are also involved as a secondary muscle group, that exercise being Otis Ups. To perform, lie on the ground face up with knees bent and feet flat. Extend arms straight out in front of you and flex your spine, rolling it up as you contract your abdominal muscles. Sit up until your chest is at your knees and your arms are straight above your head, and then roll yourself back down to the starting position. This is one of my favorite core exercises, and the fact that it also engages the delts just makes it that much better. Thank you, Otis Ups. We are on to our final day of the Buff Dude's home body weight routine, and on day five, we're gonna be working arms, a collection of muscles which are favored by many, myself included. First on the list is an exercise called diamond push-ups, a close grip press-like exercise. It's a compound movement, mostly focusing on your tricep muscles due to the narrow grip, and called diamond because of the position of your hands creating a diamond-like shape. How to perform? Go ahead and take the classic push-up position and bring your hands together in the diamond shape. Keep your back straight, your scapula retracted, and turn your elbows inwards. Slowly go down while controlling your movement, and once there, extend to the top position. Next, we'll be performing another excellent triceps focus exercise called the alternating cross chair dips. The alternating from one side to another, helping to give your triceps an even bigger challenge. Place your palms on two chairs and have your arms slightly outside shoulder width. Go down slowly, leaning towards one of your arms, go up to the top position in the center, and repeat for the other arm. You wanna try and keep your back straight, close to the chairs, and if you're a beginner, you can bend your knees more to help yourself with the weight. If you have any muscle imbalances, feel free to do a few more reps on the weaker side for each set performed. That's what makes unilateral exercises so great, because you can focus on those imbalances. And our final triceps focus exercise will be praying mantis push-ups, my favorite bodyweight triceps exercise, one which really helps to isolate and focus on the tricep muscles. To perform, take the standard push-up position. Slightly step back so your hands are more in line with your head. Slowly go down, bringing your forearms parallel to the ground. Next, push yourself up using your triceps back to the starting position. This exercise is a bit more advanced, so if you're a beginner, try to really take your time and slowly work on improving your form. Keep your elbows close to your body for better triceps isolation, and don't keep your shoulders as retracted as you normally would with pressing motions, because you want to avoid a chest activation in this exercise as much as possible. Now it's time for some biceps, and we'll be starting with underhand inverted rows. Much like the standard inverted rows we performed on back day, the only difference with this one is you'll be using a supinated grip with your palms facing upwards. Due to this fact, you'll find yourself slightly compromised underneath the table, so don't get too excited and rip yourself into the top position, which could smash your buff dude brain. Instead, go ahead and pull yourself up slow and controlled and really squeeze the biceps once you reach top position. We'll be following up this exercise with a single arm underhand inverted rows, with the key difference being we'll only be using one arm at a time and we'll be starting at the top position, squeezing in the biceps and letting ourselves down with each rep as slowly as possible. Once you've reached the floor, spring back up into the top position and continue your arm wrestling contest with the table. Believe me, it's a tough one. And now we are on to our final exercise of our Buff Dude's home workout routine journey, and it's going to be a core exercise utilizing triceps as a secondary muscle group worked. They're called the tuck push-ups. Get into a push-up position and bring your chest to the ground. Once doing so, push with your triceps, and as soon as you've cleared enough room, bring your knees up to your chest, flexing in your core. Kick your feet back and immediately bring your chest back to the ground. Three sets of 12 reps later, and you're finished. Whew. There you go, buff dudes and girls, the Buff Dude's home bodyweight workout routine. As I said earlier in the video, feel free to perform this routine either Monday through Friday, every other day, or any time which fits into your schedule. If you'd like even more home bodyweight routines, feel free to pick up our bodyweight book, link in description. Please let us know if you enjoyed this video, and until next time, stay safe, stay sane, and stay buff. Yeah.